With these hit and miss engines, there seems to be an occasional problem with the ignition system where the engine's running and then it just quits and you can't get it going again for a while. And it appears to come back to the voltage that's going into the ignition module. And instead of using three AA batteries, if we can use just two, it drops the voltage and that problem seems to go away. Now, my initial battery blank, this was printed on a 3D printer, and this is a piece of piano wire, and that seemed to be pretty simple to me, but we're going to try to do this a little bit different. I take a 9-penny nail, I cut it off, and this head is textured, and that's so the hammer head doesn't slip off the nail, supposedly. First thing I do is I grind that flat and get rid of that texture. And then I cut this a little bit longer than 50 millimeters and then grind it back to exactly 50 millimeters. I've designed a different one of these for the 3D printer. It's got a little bit of a pocket there for that head to go into. The bottom side of this head is a little bit tapered. So there's a pocket here and there's chamfered on the inside. Take care of that taper and that pushes in there and it just protrudes by a couple of millimeters. What's nice about this 9-penny nail just goes into that rivet. It kind of pops in there and it helps keep that centered because these things do jump up and down, bounce around a bit, so it could shake a battery loose. I haven't had that happen, but so then the head of the nail goes against the spring and that indexes. And the job of this plastic is to keep that nail centered. And that is exactly the same length as a AA battery. Now, that's if you have access to a 3D printer. If you do not, you can take a 1/2-inch wood dowel and cut this to 1 7/8 inches, which is about 48 millimeter. Drill a hole through it, and that's good enough. If you don't have a way of machining this pocket like I show here in a minute, you can cut this dowel back to about 45 millimeters and use it like that. 1/2-inch wooden dowel. 1 7/8 inches long, or about 47 millimeter. And I'm going to drill a 5/32 hole in the center of the dowel. So using the end mill, I just machined a little pocket for the head of that nail to go into a little bit. And because the underside of this nail is a bit tapered, I'm going to chamfer the hole. Now, let me put the nail in here. The nail goes into the wood a little bit, and I can press that down a little more. The shaft of the nail sticks out past the wood on this side. nine-penny nail, flatten the head, shorten it to 50 millimeters. The STL file will be on Thingiverse under my name, and there will be a link in the description for this video.